set. 3, 2, 1, action.
Wait, do we even have scripts?
Sorry guys, this week we have limited content.
That won't do. I'll go find Crevel in her office. Come on in. We have a problem. We have limited content.
Well, what are our options?
I think we should open up the vault.
Well, desperate times. Do what you have to do.
See something strange.
Come with us and you will see. This our show of Halloween. This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Pumpkins scream in the dead of night. This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene. Trick or treat. Tell the neighbors on the drive.
Hi Mountain High, Corello here with a history of Halloween. Now, you may know Halloween as this crazy day where we dress up and have candy and there are kind of crazy parties, maybe you go to a haunted house, but it's not actually always been that way. Halloween is almost 2,000 years old and started as a pagan holiday, mostly to celebrate the end of summer. As a matter of fact, the celebration that we have most closely resembles the Celtic holiday of Samhain. Samhain, which literally means the end of summer. Halloween comes from the idea that it is All Hallows' Eve. Hallows' Eve becomes Halloween becomes Halloween. And it is 2 days before All Souls' Day. We have Halloween, we have All Saints' Day, which is a day to celebrate all of the saints in the canon, and then All Souls' Day, which is November 2nd, to celebrate the souls of the dearly departed dead people in our lives.
Remember me, though I have to say goodbye. Remember me, don't let it make you cry. For even if I'm far away, I hold you in my heart. I sing a secret song to you each night we are apart. Remember me.
So those of us who are familiar with Dia de los Muertos from the outside might be most familiar with the calandera, like the sugar skulls, or people dressing up with the Dia de los Muertos face makeup, or the big flowers in their hair, the marigolds, or the colorful dresses. But it's actually a really sacred holiday. And something that we have is ofrendas. What's an ofrenda, Miss Alexia?
That is where you bring peace offerings to the dead.
So I know that you can bring things like their picture or like a candle, but what is something else that we could bring as an offering to this this ofrenda?
You can take them their favorite food, or if they're kids, you can take them toys and just things like that.
So all in all, a really cool way to celebrate your ancestors, whether you dress up, whether you celebrate with an ofrenda and Dia de los Muertos, but whatever you choose to do this holiday weekend, please make sure that you are safe and you make good choices.
Thank you, Crivello, for that information that we all didn't know.
Now here's the crew with a Halloween candy taste test.
Let's eat some Halloween candies.
Let's try these ones first. There's that one, that one, that one.
Is it hard?
Mm-hmm.
Is that caramel?
It tastes like... Can't stand that.
Dominic's gonna go with the vomitous unidentified candy. And Dominique is going to try the crispy, crunchy, chocolatey, smooth skulls.
It seriously smells like it's a bag of chips.
It doesn't smell bad.
Is that black licorice? There's black licorice in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's cheap chocolate. That's not good.
All right. Here, my boys, I got you guys some wax pumpkins.
Ooh.
Yeah, they're quite delicious. Yeah, that's wax, all right.
Mixes real well with the,
you know,
a sucker, that's for sure.
Not gonna lie, these aren't too bad. Kind of like candy corn.
They taste like wax. I can't.
These are fire, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for that terrible experience with that terrible candy.
Before we move forward, here's a look back at some recent events. AJ has looked back at our day of service helping Utah refugees.
Last Tuesday, we had a day of service sponsored by DECA. Students learned about the refugees and their experiences and helped make 215 hygiene kits, 7 quilts with the help from $885 raised from Penny Wars. Mountain High students really are the best. Lastly, we get to shave Greg's head because we made enough money. So they're a dollar a ticket, and you can get them at the office.
Finally, we'll start the Christmas season with Raquel in the wreath competition that was started in advisory classes.
Recently, we had the advisories have a wreath decorating contest. So how about we go and check out some of the best looking ones? First up, here we have Mindy's wreath. As you can see, it's a reindeer. I think it's so creative the way that they used all these plastic things, and honestly, it's pretty awesome. Here we have Tyler with an obsession with Mountain Dew. Very interesting here, very unique style. Here we have Natalie's wreath. Obviously, you can see the ribbons, different colors. Honestly, very simple, but very cute. And here we have John G's masterpiece with so many snowflakes and just a winter wonderland. And here we have Paula's wreath. As you can see, it's lit up, and honestly, it's probably my favorite one, but shh. And here we have Susanna's wreath. As you can see, very scholarly, I like it. Here is Ryan's wreath. They used newspaper, which I thought was very creative. Obviously, as you can tell, this one is Cheryl's. Absolutely beautiful, stunning, elegant, just perfect. And as you can see, the custodians did an awesome job with their wreath. Amazing. Here we have Jamie's wreath, as you can see, super adorable. Here we have Janie's wreath, as you can see, very unique with the popcorn and the skateboards. Here we have Tommy's wreath, as you can see, it's a wreath with wreaths on it. Great. And here we have Cody's wreath. Here we have Margie's wreath, obviously she had to bring her crochet game strong. Here we have Travis's famous Halloween wreath. And as you can see, Crivello really brought it with this wreath, man. Here we have Fede's very original creative cookie wreath. Lastly, we have Brent, who wanted to show off the art of simplicity because empty space is beautiful. So we got the results of the wreath competition, and first place was Mindy. Here we have Paula's lovely wreath in second place. And here we have the lovely CTE's wreath that we never showed, but they got third place.
Before we officially go, here's some information on the new LEGO class on Fridays.
Hey Mountain High, we have a brand new class starting on Fridays during 10th period. It's going to be Make a Stop Motion Video with LEGOs. We're looking for kids who want to do videography and photography. We want kids who want to build sets with Legos. We need voice actors and musicians to help make background music and sound effects. And finally, we need kids who are really good at video editing to come and learn software with Brent and help put the videos all together. It'll be great. 10th period on Fridays. Come join us. See you there.
Thanks for joining us.
See you next week, Mountain High.